I'm going to show you a fun exercise using the thumb in the style of rumba flamenco Spanish guitar. It might look challenging at first, but we're going to break it down step by step. You're going to like this. Let's do it. Hi there, I'm Thomas Michaud from Real Guitar Success, where I help you learn guitar and, more importantly, love the journey. If you're new here, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that little bell so I can send you more guitar lessons and learning tips. This thumb technique is something I use often in my music. If you'd like to hear a good example of it, check out the song Night in Antigua on my Passion Dance CD. You can find it on Amazon.com, but I'll go ahead and put a link to it in the description below so you can find it easily. I'm going to break it down into three steps. We'll start off with a basic technique. So I'm using my thumb and I'm pressing down through the string of the guitar. Start with the low E string and just try this. Now, a couple of things. I'm not moving my arm up and down. I'm driving through the string, but I'm using my wrist and the motion of my thumb. This is a waste of energy and it won't work. The other thing is I'm not pulling out from the string like this. That's a softer sound. It's called a free stroke and often used in classical guitar. We're doing what's commonly called a rest stroke, where you drive through the string. It's louder and more forceful. So let's practice a basic exercise just to get used to using the thumb like that. We're just going to go on the sixth string and go up by half steps. I'm going to stop on the third finger because we're working on the right hand. Open A. And then go to the fourth string. That's a D. Now, one thing, if you look at my right hand, I'm keeping my first finger actually resting on the first string. We want to keep the finger right where it is and all the motion is in the wrist and thumb. Again, I'm not moving my arm. Let's do that again, one more time. Go ahead and try it with me now. Going on the fifth string. And the fourth string. This time we'll go backwards as well. So practice this exercise going all the way up by half steps, just to the fourth string, and then go back down. Now you want to practice it enough so that you feel like you can hit the string pretty much every time. It doesn't have to be perfect, but when you feel like you're about 80% of where you can do it, up to our average tempo, we'll go on to step number two. Okay, for step number two, we're going to specifically work on the notes that are in the exercise. So make it A minor chord, so that you can finger the notes properly. You're going to start with the A string, then finger with the pinky, third fret, going down by half steps. I'm using my second finger, then open. Now to the sixth string, that's third fret. First finger moves over. It's okay if the other fingers come off, you won't need them. And then open. So that's part of the A minor scale. Let's start again. Make the A minor chord, and you'll see why that's important. Open A, pinky, going down half step, second finger. Open, pinky on the sixth string, first finger. It's okay, the other fingers come off. So a little faster. That's step number two. Practice that again until you feel relatively comfortable with it. We're not going for perfection. You're going to put it all together and then practice it even more. Now for step number three, and we're going to actually break this into two parts. This is the technique we're after. So the first thing is just to practice that first chord. You're hitting two bass notes and then picking off with the first finger. Two bass notes. Try that with me, just quickly. Thumb, fifth string, fourth string, and first finger in the first string. One more time. Now we're going to add those scale notes from the A minor scale. First, the open, pinky, second finger. I didn't hit two bass notes there. Open. Then we go down to the sixth string. And again, I only hit the bass note one time. First finger. And then open. A little faster. So start slowly. Break it into two halves. First half is like this. Try that with me, nice and slow. A minor chord, ready, go. Now we'll go on to the sixth string. Again, slowly. Now all together. And again, slowly. And you can hit the E chord. A little faster. I hope you've enjoyed this lesson. If you haven't already, subscribe to my YouTube channel and click that little bell so you don't miss a thing. Did you find this lesson helpful? Let me know in the comments. I really want to know what you have to say. And I'd love to hear your suggestions for other videos you'd like to see me make. And don't forget, this is all about loving your guitar learning journey. Life's short. Give it your best. Bye for now.